myself. I'm a man of wealth and taste. I've been around for a long, long year.
Yeah, very pleased. I'm certainly impressed with the sort of performance of it. We probably had sort of up to about 10, 11 knots of breeze out there, and certainly she's very lively in it, and quite exciting. The pick up both upwind and off the wind with the kites was exciting, and she's going to be quite exhilarating in any sort of breeze. You can quite clearly see the potential in the light wind, so yeah, very good.
And that's a pretty big kite for a 35-foot boat.
It's a pretty big kite for a 35-foot boat. Yeah, is that, you know, there's long luffs and leeches with it, and which just means that there's a lot of trimming required with it, constant trimming with it. You know, the guys are up for this. We're going to have about 3 or 4 weeks of sort of crew training and selection. Make sure that all the sails are okay, and deal with all the little fine-tuning bits you have to with these new boats. Then basically we're going down to Plymouth then for 6 weeks to do again more training and crew work. We're then back up here for the Round the Island race, where we're hoping to have sort of probably 10 of these X35s doing it. And then that will culminate with the IRC Nationals and then the first X35 National Championship. Where we are hoping, as I say, to have sort of 12 boats here. Maybe we might be able to entice some of the Dutch fleet over to bolster it. But for the one design boat, it's going to be a good start.
Yeah, and I understand you're planning to do the Rolex Fastnet as well, now.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, I can't get rid of my offshore stuff just yet. So we have to take the boat back to Plymouth after the X35 Nationals. So we thought the easiest way to do it is take it via the Fastnet Rock.
Tell me, how many of these boats have been sold? How many X35s are
there? Well, worldwide now, they've just had the 250th order. This is hull number 103, and they've roughly been out for 18 months, so there's been a big uptake in the design. I think it appeals to an awful lot of people because it's affordable that a privateer can take this on. The concept of one design obviously is becoming very popular. First over the line is the winner. It's not stopwatch sailing. And I think this is sort of something that is going to catch on. I mean, we've seen with both the J fleets and the X fleets the success of the X99 332. And I'm sure the X boats have got a bit of a winner here as well. 35 feet is a nice size. It's a manageable size. We sail with 7/8 people on board. So getting a crew is not the hardest thing in the world to do with it. They've been quite generous with their weight allowance, where we sail in the UK with 680 kilograms. We're going to all have to tune up a bit for the Worlds in 2008, because that's down to 640 kilograms. But that's basically our program. Is, you know, this year is to learn all about the boat, get our sail selection right, with then the intention that the boat is going to then go off to do these World and European Championships in 2008 season.
Right, and tell me, Nigel, you're from Plymouth. Where are the rest of the crew from?
The base of the crew will be sort of Plymouth lads, and obviously our tactician Kevin Sproul from Elstrom Sobstadt is, you know, based in the Solent, which is sort of quite good for us this year with the Nationals being in the Solent. But predominantly we're West Country boys, yeah.